Hi, I'm Paul Robbins, and here's something you may not have known about agriculture. You know, farmers and ranchers have been providing food for our dinner tables for thousands of years, but you really can't talk about the history of crops without mentioning salt. Now, it's not really a food, of course, but we do harvest salt to spice up our meals. Salt in small doses is essential for animal life, and it has a long history of being used as a preservative. But while we take that shaker of salt on our table for granted, that shiny mineral has a very spicy history. Dial back the time clock to prehistoric days, and some ancient communities got their salt by evaporating the mineral from salt-laden rivers and lakes. Salt miners later began digging up salt from underground deposits. Salt was in demand, not only for its flavor, but also for its ability to preserve foods by inhibiting the growth of bacteria. In the Middle Ages, salt was so expensive, it was referred to as white gold. Some historians say that the expression, "not worth his salt," originated in ancient Greece, where salt was traded for slaves. Salt has been used in many ways throughout the ages, not only in food production and preservation, but also to make soap, glass, and in some types of chemical processes. And if you live in a snowy winter region, well, rock salt might be used to de-ice highways in your area. Oh, and let's not forget the Bible when it comes to salt. One of the earliest known references to salt is in the book of Job, written about 2200 BC. And of course, y'all know about Lot's wife, who was turned into a pillar of salt when she turned and looked back at that wicked city of Sodom. Now, some say that if you look closely at the painting of the Last Supper, you'll see that Judas has knocked the salt cellar over with his elbow. So, thanks to Judas, spilled salt is associated with treachery, and throwing a pinch of salt over your left shoulder is supposed to blind the devil waiting to cash in on your clumsiness. And I think I'll stick with pepper.